Welcome to the National Greenhouse and Energy Reporting Training Video Series. This series is delivered by the Clean Energy Regulator and aims to help you report under the National Greenhouse and Energy Reporting Act 2007, also known as the NGER Act. This video will cover the emissions estimation methods and fuel measurement criteria available under the NGER Act. There is a range of terms used in this video that have a specific meaning, including Clean Energy Regulator, NGER, Determination, NGER Act, and EARS. To learn what each of these means, please refer to the video Introduction to the Clean Energy Regulator and NGER from the NGER Training Video Series, available by following the links at the end of this video. In the first part of the video, we describe the methods that are available for estimating direct and indirect greenhouse gas emissions under the determination. So, what are emissions estimation methods? Emissions are rarely measured through direct observation. They are most often estimated by referencing readily observable variables that are closely related to greenhouse gas emissions, such as the quantity of fossil fuels consumed. In the determination, there are four methods available for estimating Scope 1 emissions, and two methods available for estimating Scope 2 emissions. Reporters can choose which of these methods they will use, noting that not all methods are available for all sources of emissions. Where available as an option, reporters may select different methods for each source. Generally speaking, the higher the method, the more accurate the estimates are. Reporters can use their own judgment to balance the costs of using the higher methods with the benefits of potentially improved emissions estimates. For estimating Scope 1 emissions, Method 1 is the default method. It applies emission factors based on national average estimates. In EARS, these default emission factors are built in such a way that emissions are automatically calculated for you. Method 2 is a facility-specific method that uses industry-specific procedures for sampling and Australian standards, international standards, or equivalent standards for analysis of fuels and raw materials. This provides more accurate estimates of emissions at the facility level. Method 2 enables corporations to undertake additional measurements, such as the qualities of fuels consumed at a particular facility, in order to gain more accurate estimates for emissions for that facility. For example, this may involve sampling the carbon and moisture content in coal, or measuring the composition of each component gas type in unprocessed natural gas. Method 3 is a facility-specific method using Australian standards, international standards, or equivalent standards listed in the determination for both sampling and analysis of fuels and raw materials. Method 3 is very similar to Method 2, except that it requires reporters to comply with Australian or equivalent documentary standards for sampling of fuels or raw materials, as well as for the analysis of fuels. Method 4 is a direct monitoring of emission systems, either on a continuous or periodic basis. Method 4 provides a different approach to the estimation of emissions. Rather than providing for the analysis of the chemical properties of inputs, or in some cases products, Method 4 aims to directly monitor greenhouse emissions arising from an activity. This approach can provide a higher level of accuracy in certain circumstances, depending on the type of emissions process. This method is likely to be more data-intensive than other approaches. In the determination, Scope 2 emissions are indirect emissions that result from the consumption of purchased electricity generation or through the loss of electricity from an electricity transmission network or distribution network. There are two Method 1s available in Chapter 7 of the determination. The first method is available for estimating emissions from electricity purchased or lost from the main electricity grid in a state or territory. The second method is available for estimating emissions from electricity purchased or lost from sources other than the main grid. For more details on how to report Scope 2 emissions, please see the Reporting Scope 2 Emissions video in the NGER Training Video Series. A link is provided at the end of this video. In this second part of the video, we describe the measurement criteria available in the determination, which are reported against the consumption and production of each fuel or energy type listed in Schedule 1. So, what are measurement criteria? Measurement criteria are rules by which the base quantities for determining the amounts of greenhouse gas emissions and energy consumption are to be estimated for the purposes of the NGER Act. These rules may set out how the following are to be estimated: the amount of fuel consumed or combusted for a source, the quantity of fuel throughputs related to fugitive emissions from the extraction, production, processing, and distribution of fossil fuels, the amount of carbonates consumed, synthetic gas emitted, and fuel used as a feedstock or as carbon reductant related to industrial process emissions, or the amount of waste for a source. There are four different measurement criteria available: Criterion A, Criterion AA, Criterion AAA, and Criterion BBB. When acquisitions involve a commercial transaction, there are three measurement criteria options: Criterion A for quantities verified by invoices, Criterion AA for indirect measurement, such as verifying quantities by stockpile change estimation and invoices, and Criterion AAA for measurements taken at the point of sale or fuel combustion. When invoices for fuels consumed are not available, there are two measurement criteria options: Criterion AAA for measurements taken at the point of fuel consumption or at the point of sale, and Criterion BBB for quantities measured or estimated in accordance with industry practice. Criterion A might be applied, for example, to fuel invoices when diesel is delivered for use at the facility purchased from a vendor. Criterion AA might be used, for example, for changes of purchased or stockpiled fuel for use on site, such as gasoline or coal. Invoiced quantities are adjusted for the estimated change in quantity of the stockpile of fuel during the year, noting that the methods differ by the fuel state, such as gas, liquid, or solid. Criterion AAA might be used, for example, where measurements are taken at the point of combustion of coal used to generate electricity, or at the point of sale via fuel dispensers at petrol stations. These measurements must be undertaken in accordance with measuring equipment and methodologies specified in the determination. And finally, Criterion BBB might be used, for example, for production of secondary oil products at a crude oil refinery, or own gas consumption at a liquefied natural gas terminal. Criterion BBB is used for measurements in accordance with industry practice, and can only be used if the fuel cannot be measured under Criteria A, AA, or AAA. Therefore, fuels that can be verified using supply invoices cannot be measured using Criterion BBB. Industry practice is not defined in the NGER legislation. However, we consider it to be what would reasonably be expected to occur at a competent, similar facility type of a similar size and age. Note that any methods implemented using Criterion BBB should comply with the general principles under Section 1.13 of the determination. This includes that uncertainties in estimates must be minimized to ensure estimates are not statistically significantly different from their true value. This video is from the NGER training video series. The Clean Energy Regulator has published a range of resources on its website, www.cleanenergyregulator.gov.au, to help you in your obligations to report under the NGER Act. To access our training video series, visit our website and search videos. To access our more comprehensive written guidance documents, visit our website and search guides and fact sheets. To access calculators to assist you in assessing reporting obligations, estimating uncertainty in emissions, and estimating emissions from solid waste and wastewater operations, visit our website and search calculators. For more information or help with reporting under the NGER scheme, please contact us by calling 1300 553 542, emailing us at reporting@cleanenergyregulator.gov.au, or visiting our website at www.cleanenergyregulator.gov.au. This video has been developed by the Clean Energy Regulator to assist persons to comply with their reporting obligations under the NGER Act. This video should be viewed in conjunction with the NGER Act and supporting regulations and determination. Changes to legislation may affect the information in this video. The examples used in this video are for illustrative purposes only. This video is not intended to provide legal advice. If persons have concerns or questions about the application of legislation in their particular circumstances, they should seek professional advice.